guys, your boy Crepers, and welcome back to my 516 Olympic Marseille Corona. Oh, well. Last time. Left. Oh, fine. If the business in the cup and in the league, which allowed me to get to the final, put my place in the final of the French League Cup against PSG, who I actually have in this episode in the league. But first, I must hit him who I've already played twice this season, and this will be my third game against them. It's Montpellier. So far, I've scored 7 against them, conceded 1. They were the first team to score a goal against me in the league, and they must pay for that. Above all else, I need to reestablish my 18-point lead before I go into the PSG game, so I can make the gap 21 points. Yeah. Talk. Even for PSG, that lead will be unassailable.
Big warm welcome to you from myself.
So, let's do this.
Warm actually isn't the word, really, not here in the stadium, with the snow coming down.
Yeah, it's a bit chilly, don't want to keep moving down there, but the snow for the moment doesn't seem to be settling too much.
I have nothing particularly to talk about in terms of real-life football-wise. I mean, I could discuss Man United's 2-0 victory over Southampton last night, but I really don't want to, so I'm not going to. So I'll just talk over this game. Hey, here's Pasha White, running towards goal. Will he score? Straight at the keeper. Brilliant. Great start, though. Ladies and gentlemen. Well, sometimes. I'm excited to get early goals, but not on this occasion. Here's Ngidou, who, while I was looking over the stats, I learned he has 14 assists so far in the league. So, he's made a big contribution in setting up a lot of my goals. So I'm thankful for that. Of course, it's no good having someone who will set up goals if you don't have someone to convert them. I have top 3 goal scorers in the league. You get them. I'm in Chalalu with 19 goals, Bashoy with 17, and Benyit with 11.
Well, it's very difficult.
Oh, and could do all the goals he set up, he almost scored there. Just over the bar, a little lower. It would have needed to be a bit more and a little bit lower, and I just hit the crossbar. Nothing would have been accomplished. It was very good. Pull again and wins the corner. Chalavu! Oof. There's Remy. Me? Of course. He is the player who scored said goal all against me in our last league meeting with Marseille, as it's made 1-0, and it's 20 league goals for Hakan Çalhanoğlu.
And that was that team.
Ooh, I think that took a deflection, but I don't think it's not going to be given as his goal. Tell, 14, and I think it was 26, oh? Yeah, it definitely hit 14, wherever 14 is, for Montpellier. if I'm not mistaken. Definitely looked like it hit his upper arm.
And that has opened the score.
It's in as a hot channel of those goals, so that is 20 goals for the season. And that is quite the achievement. I don't know if there's ever a situation. I don't know what the, if there's a record for goals a player has scored in their first season in the, channel. It must be,
He's
got to be. Really. He's testing more stats there might be. Unlucky from the header from Tovan.
That worked pretty well until the shot.
Just wide. You know, making it 2-0.
Tovan.
There's Chalobu.
We could be it.
Thing to do.
Diarra.
Diarra. It's 15. Yeah, assists for Harrington, who, and that is Diarra's fourth league goal of the season.
The ability to use the neck muscles like that. Great header.
Which is weird. I don't remember him scoring. I remember him scoring two. I don't remember him scoring a third. He obviously did. Because I play every match. This is it's weird.
Raining.
I remember scoring. I remember three of his goals, obviously. That one included, but I remember him scoring four. And obviously. Maybe he scored in like a big victory and I just can't remember. Rick.
He gives it back to his teammates.
I'm sure it'll come anywhere if I'm for what I might do is I look up I can look over the matches in the previous episodes and see where that goal was.
Shots on
here. Not sure why he hit that first, I'll be honest, but it doesn't matter. The score is 2-0 at the and channel who getting the goals. So all down the center or so far. Or with the center attacking men, the center defensive made both scoring goals. In the first half.
Real good contest between these two. They jostle for possession.
Let's see if I can add another goal. That's what. Hey, I should at least add one more goal because in the past twice now I've been. Montpellier by a gap of 3 goals. 3-0 in the cup and 4-1 in the league.
He's got support here.
Montpellier are not playing as good as they could hit on the in December. This is more like the cup tie. Which, really enough, was at their stadium. Maybe it was because they came to my stadium and they decided to play it better because it is 3-0, it's Rekic. A defender, center defender, ironically, has added goal number 3. Ironically, Rekic scored against Montpellier the first time I played him as well. So,
given them a comfortable situation.
His season almost comes full circle. Well, in a way. Kind of way, but in some form or a way.
Here's a chance to move.
There is the 3-goal gap. Can I perhaps...
Just a quick note for your diaries.
Change the stats and get a 4-goal without conceding.
They'll be facing Lorient away from home.
Oh, it was just too easy to sweat the bet. And the other, he was wide open for it.
The touch of a maestro.
The keeper was focusing too much on Gianluca. He's like, yeah, I've got discovered, and then I passed it. And he's like, oh shit. 4 turn.
The other very off colour.
Pull of 3. That takes the goal difference against Montpellier so far to plus 10 goals now. Because it was at plus 6. Now score 11 and see 1. Make that score 12. Can see 1. As it's another fantastic goal from Hackage. Logo. Ooh, that is just superb. Look at this again. Comes in. Why, just hit. He hit it first time. That was first time. He didn't take a touch. He hit it first time. And gave the keeper absolutely no chance. The keeper didn't even... He didn't even bother. He didn't even bother. Maybe he took a touch. Well, where it did or didn't. It's given as a channel Google, well, as it should. Even if it took a deflection, the keeper should have at least made an effort. I mean, because it was his way of showing how good shot that was. I mean, it wouldn't win. In a goal of the season, or unless it was a quiet season, there are much better goals that have been scored, not just in FIFA's in general, but in real life.
Marseille now in possession again. Gregory van der Veel.
That is a pretty good goal. Here's Tovan.
Cross, good block.
The cross is blocked so it doesn't find its way to the channel logo.
How about Marseille's next game?
Well, they're playing Paris Saint-Germain in their next match in Ligue 1. The two managers have summed it up. I think there's not going to be much between them.
They want to keep the stats the same. Montpellier need to quick fire in 2 goals before the end of this match. Else they're going to lose to me by a bigger margin on this occasion. Benyara is keen to make sure it's as big as possible. Channel go for the hat trick! And he gets it! Benyara was very unselfish. There, and Chalogu will be taking on the match ball. And Montpellier have been sent packing with their tails tucked firmly between their legs. Crashed it into the roof. Right there. Twenty-two goals now for Chalogu. It's like I said, it must be, if there is a record for like goals scored by a debuting player in the league, he's either broken that a record or he's testing the record in it.
Barry Gow.
After his record that he's yet to break in terms of debuting in play.
Well, that's a win. really big win.
Well, it's a proper.
He's in the goal. Full tally. He's well on his way to the breaking. Yeah, if he hasn't already. Because, we're still playing games to go. Nice 6-0 victory. Jara got man of the match. Despite the fact that Ben Yedder also got a 9.9. And Chaloku get 3 goals, and yet 2 players scored higher than him. How the hell's that? How the hell does that work out? Three goals and an assist. And he still gets the second highest rating. Jeez. What does a guy have to do to get the top rating, huh?
One. Now let's see what effect that's had on the league standings. At the top of the table remain Olympique Marseille with 69 points. In second, Paris Saint-Germain with 51 points. In third, Stade Rennais with 47.
You can see I'm signing up another striker just in case any injuries occur.
In fifth, rising up the table are Guillaume.
And Mendy, you were more than deserving of a new contract. Friend, you've been fantastic. Oh. All my defense has been fantastic. I mean, none of the near of the goals that I've conceded have really been your fault. Or any of the other players for that matter.
Reading up the table, second bottom, Troy, with 17 points.
Hang on a second. You adjust the wages,
but only behind on goal difference. Fifth bottom, Lille with 19 points.
I won't be here for any more transfer windows, so may as well put as much into the wages as I possibly can. So if any arises, I have the money to take whoever's wages is for whoever asks. Because, I mean, like I said, all my defenders have been solid, especially Mendy, who I'm really keeping up in terms of his development in the future FIFAs. He might be a future for signing at Liverpool for, oh, I mean, 70s. I mean, he's relatively young. A bit. And he could be a top quality left back. No. Or he'll just say he wants to leave. Well, the window is until the end of the season, so it's not my problem. I will try to get him to re-sign. And also, you see this? You see sale of shirts with the name Ben Yedder? I'm guessing that's gonna have a. You see that happen, if you got like this news feed in FIFA 17, that's going to be a good sign, because you have to like make sure that shirts are selling, and apparently I'm already doing that at one FIFA early. I'm sure we've all gotten that message at some point. If the player isn't good enough for him, that message will come up regardless. Oh. PSG play the game before they play me, so I won't be extending my lead to 21 points. It'll be 18 points, but I'll have a game in hand, which I'll more than happily take. Not quite to the finish line just yet. After this game, there'll be 14 more games, so not just not here, not 9. close to being done yet. But it's rapidly approaching. And a win here? Oh, we'll see. He coming. Just a little closer to that very important first place spot. You know what I mean? Yeah. So, let's beat PSG. And open that 18-point gap with a game in hand.
Last time out, and it's rounded off the team with these two strikers.
Of course, he's not injured this time straight away, Ibrahim, which is making himself known in this game, because of course he was in, like I said, already said, he was injured during the first encounter between me and PSG.
Easy for the goalkeeper, Kevin Trapp.
Tovan.
Here he is. Three in his last match. A hat-trick and a match ball.
Tovan again. Back in Chalamu! Off the post! Bang in there! And the people with the aim on the back can pat the back because Bang in there makes it 1-0. I bet all those people are bouncing up and down. Hey!
So many chances they've taken this
check
this
for
those boards because no shortage of chances created. Top day for them. Let's have another peek at that goal.
And Trapp is not happy. Which is understandable. Well, he feels like the defense should have been doing better, but then again, they're up against the most team in the league. When they're on, hell, even when they're not, are really firing out. So, there's been scoring goals left, right, and center. They're still kicking everyone. His ass.
Oh, he's true.
There's Ben Yedder again. Is he gonna go alone? He has special. He really chose to shoot and Trapp made this. He but the. Was the result? And Vanderbilt just ignored the ball and chose to have a weird tussle with Mkhitaryan before her saying, you know what, you can have it.
Now Robert.
That was all in all weird. Did Robert not go out and play there? Okay, fair enough. Go Mendy. Ben Yedder! 2-0! Oh, and it's the man who is selling all the shirts. And a top corner. Superb.
Restarting at 2-0.
Oh, it's looking good. It's going to be 18 points with a game in hand. Yo, this the league is pretty much won. Not for this, because if the second place team can catch me, then hope that the other teams have. Trying to make sure that they didn't take the free kick quickly.
Just worried about the rain only, in that it's carrying a bit of visibility of the proceedings out there. Easy decision.
Tovan was fouled. Yes, the referee noticed it. Okay, whip it into the box. Trying to hope find some in his head. No, it's clear to up, but it comes to bit. Yeah, no. Tobin! Oh, just wide of the post. He kind of like curved it or something. Shit.
Ian Robert.
It was, might have kind of missed, but I'm not going to allow any excuses or stop to try and count for this. I'm just going to say it was a bad miss and move on. And the wheel. Oops. It's going to come back out to him.
I think he rushed his shot there.
No one got on the end of it.
Coming up now, Alan, a quick look back at Ben Yedder's second goal. Ian Robert. Lozano Dia.
Yar. Joshua.
And the goalkeeper got a touch to that. Fine save.
Oh, if I played it over, or Trapp wouldn't have gotten to that, and now Chalagor Yedder would have scored. Tovan. Corner.
And the ball's gone out for a corner.
Which Diarra takes. It's going to come to play. Yedder, he's got that. There's Tovan.
And in
goes the cross. Straight onto Saito Bob's head, but it comes back to Tovan. And frickin' McTerran! It's okay. I'm 2-0 up. The fact that I didn't get third just yet is not a big deal. PSG are still in an unenviable position. Considering I've only conceded 2 goals in 23 games, PSG needs to score 3 against me in 1. It might be 4! Oh, Basho! He wasn't quick enough. Oh, wait. Ah, oh, when I saw the play stop, I thought it might be a foul. One Basho Hawaii. But apparently, Basho Hawaii was judged to have fouled Trapp as he was trying to get the ball. Well, for me.
Tova.
Well, not, Trapp didn't even have the ball. Well, they lashed after Trapp got rid of it.
Strong, powerful clearance.
And Saito Bock.
It's a corner now.
Up concedes another corner. Come on. Good luck. Ricky! Hey, Shirley! Off the post! He wins another corner at least.
And that'll be a corner.
Let's try this again. And this time. Comes out. Vander Wiel! Oh, imagine! Imagine the... Yeah, we know that was not over the line.
No, it certainly didn't, and the defending team were sure of that at the time as well. That's another.
Tovan! Ooh, good save by Trapp. The header! Oh, just not on target. Yo, this third goal's very elusive.
And it's Diarra. And the cross comes in now. That is a high.
Yes! It's Chalogu! Ooh. With goal number 23 for his season, and goal number 3 in the game, which should sign, seal, and deliver her the 3 points, and almost, let's say, we haven't officially won the league yet, but PSG, what can they do? How are they supposed to catch me? This will be 24 games unbeaten. With two goals conceded. In those 24 games. Unless it's PSG scoring the remaining time left in this match. But
yeah, they're playing Lille in the next match in
Ligue 1. They need a miracle. They need a miracle not only in this match, but in the league itself.
The manager on the sidelines waving his centre halves forward.
It's done. I'm saying. Oh. Basho. Hey, man. You wrap it up further. Oh, straight a trap. I tried to, like, hit it away from him, but. Trap stuck out his leg. Hey, I should have maybe put a bit more power around it. John Logan going for the spectacular!
And it's with Robin.
No such luck. I wouldn't have put it past him. It might have gone and had the defender not gone away. Oh, but that goes in. Ben Hare scores his hat trick. Like that should definitely wrap it up.
Because it's given him the hat trick.
Yeah, and he'll be taking home that match ball.
If he wants it and gets the better of Trapp. And he also makes Dao Luiz just for the hell of it. It's 15 goals now for Benya for in the league. He's only two behind. And, Special White, forgot the name that for a second. But yeah. If Special White doesn't, score, Chris, who knows? Oops. Oh, that might be a bad challenge. It's only a yellow. It is only a yellow for Mendy. Hey. I was fearful it might be worse, just to be honest. But luckily, the referee, I don't know if he was lenient or if he just didn't consider that a red card challenge. They seriously replaced our left back with it, Lucas.
Javier Pastore. Zlatan Ibrahimovic.
Okay, interesting choice.
It was made too easy for him.
Strangely, he from the current champions.
Angel Di Maria, and the cross is in. And he claims the cross. It was well. It's nothing.
And then that hit that down the pitch. Not been challenged. Pitch. The referee should blow up any second now.
Terrific tackle.
Hit it far, hit wide. Still no? I get you had 4 minutes, but come on, they're up.
To back their team, and they've had the results from it.
Yeah.
There we go. Oh, well, there's the full-time whistle.
They've been chasing.
Oh. Oh, and it's. Job just about done. Ben Yedda was the star of this match. Had with 3 goals. Helping seal PSG. 4-0. Oh, just so dominating.
3-0-2.
What can I say?
At the top of the table remain Olympique Marseille with 72 points, with a game in hand on the team below. In second, Paris Saint-Germain with 54 points. In third, Saint-Étienne with 50 points. In fourth, Stade Rennais.
Next up, so I have Saint-Étienne in the Coupe Nationale, which is a French equivalent of the FA Cup. And I will also have a league game in Nice.
Behind on goal difference. In eighth.
But yeah. That's it for this. So, a very successful episode. So yeah, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Smash the like button, read, hit subscribe for more videos very, very soon. Until next time, hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.